No prayers, no hidden fees. That's transparency.
No!
IBM, you to the power of IBM. FI, the all-new Accord.
Oh, yeah.
Carvana.
Yes, dealers. Huh? Yeah?
The key for Fernet is to not go down here. Just stay on your feet and watch the big guys come and push number 27 down the field as the Steelers have him airborne. 10 yards on the carry and push.
And 6 yards after initial contact. So it's first down for Jacksonville. High School, 51-yard interception return for a touchdown.
first meeting with the Steelers. Nickel package, Aaron Colvin is in. He had a pick last week in the win over Buffalo. Third and 11.
Watch up,
Dow from the gun.
Steelers versus Jaguars.
Miles Jack. It's an interception for Jacksonville. Vance McDonald, the intended receiver. And the Jaguars continue to haunt Ben Roethlisberger.
Well, they say that Jack's got the speed to match up with the tight ends, and here he shows not only the speed, but the athleticism, the control, the feet. Down inbounds for the interception. Looking like a wide receiver here after he tracks that ball down. Checks out where his feet are.
And he goes camera placement. He's got the hands as well. This nightmare just continues for Pittsburgh. Todd Haley and Ben Roethlisberger having a conversation. Jacksonville takes over inside the Steelers 20. Ball handed in front of Fournette. 5.5 to go here in the first.
Oh, yeah. He'd get off the touchdown.
He's got the key block here as he kicks out on Sean Davis. The hurdle there, and now Fournette is eyeing the pylon, and he's in. His right foot inside the goal line. Watch his right foot here. Touchdown.
Oh, my God.
Fournette trying to take that angle, and he stepped on that pylon.
That's a touchdown.
I'm with him.
There's the challenge flag from Doug Marrone.
He's so strong that he handled that hit from Joe Hayden.
Jacksonville is challenging the ruling on the field that the runner was out of bounds from the goal line. We'll review the play.
So they'll take a look.
Well, Fournette goes 228. Joe Hayden about a buck 95. And it was no contest, right? At the goal line here. There's 21 is Hayden. Trying to go high.
Where's the ball? He cupped it to his body and curled it inside.
Jaguar players that just saw the replay on the big board here are celebrating. And even if it's not a touchdown, the Jags have the ball on the 1-inch line, wouldn't they?
Let's do it. Keep going.
Leonard Fournette.
Nice dude. Let's go.
Oh my God. Touchdown of the day for the rookie.
Hey, Jaguar.
He showed that speed. We saw the power and the athleticism on his first touchdown when he went over the top from 2 yards out. This time he had great blocking.
After reviewing the play, the ruling on the field has been changed.
Jaguar's in.
Jaguars. Just like that, an extra point away from a 14-0 lead for Jacksonville.
I see Mason
Roethlisberger intercepted.
Mason Miller.
The Jaguars already have more points today than they had last week in their playoff win over Buffalo. Jack the pick. Jacksonville keeping the Pittsburgh territory, and then Leonard Fournette does the rest. Yeah. Fancy footwork along the sideline. Doug Marrone and Company, 14-0 to open up. The NFL on CBS is sponsored by Pizza Hut. No one out pizzas the Hut. And by QuickBooks, smarter business tools for the world's hardest workers. Steelers are stunned here in the opening quarter. Leonard Fournette now has 4 rushing touchdowns this season in Heinz Field. That's more than Le'Veon Bell, the all-pro running back. move the 25-yard line. Steelers have run just six offensive plays, Dad, and they're already in a huge hole.
Well, but they've got a lot of time to get out of that hole. What they really got to do is just settle down and try to get something established. Like, hey, let's try to get a first down. Let's not worry about getting it all back in one play. Antonio Brown has got to be a major factor here to get these Steelers feeling good about themselves. It's up to run against this jacked-up front four of the Jaguars.
6-2 at home this season. Losses to Jacksonville and New England. That's it.
Oh my God. Oh my God. He catches on 45.
And he turns it into a 20-yard pickup. Good block by
look at him.
Castro right here alongside of Marcus Gilbert and the tight end Jesse James. That's a huge roll. No hesitation that time by Bell. As he gets through the hole to the second level.
Whoa.
It just shucks off to Sean Gibson, protecting the ball as he knows traffic is coming. Huge play for the Steelers.
Waits, and nothing develops. No gain on the play. Telvin Smith was all over it as we check in with Evan Washburn.
Well, guys, just a sense of the Steelers sideline after this nightmare start. It's stunned, as you mentioned, I'm, and silent. The two primary voices of motivation, though, there's Hayward Bay on the offensive side. Mike Tomlin came over to the defensive line, gave them a strong message about how they need to be disciplined in stopping this Hornet rushing attack.
They allowed 231 rushing yards in the first meeting, and that was 6.2 yards per carry. Obviously padded by the 90 yards. Off to the outside, caught by Brown. He's got a first down. Brown gets his first touch in a matchup with the outstanding young corner Jalen Ramsey, and the crowd reacts and covers 11 yards.
Yeah, he's going to be a playmaker. Bell first down, and now here is Brown with the catch and the determination and drive to pick up the first down. Ramsey with a lot of cushion that time on Brown, allowed for that short pass to be turned into a first down.
NFL record, 5 straight seasons with 100 or more catches for Antonio Brown. Bill receiver set. Pittsburgh in Jacksonville territory. Roethlisberger hooks a pass. High one. Held on to Rodgers. The concentration, that body control for 13.
And the hops at 5-10 to go up high. This ball looked like it was going to be overthrown by Roethlisberger. But Rodgers, who only had 18 catches in the regular season, good protection for Big Ben as he sees the hole. And look at the concentration by Rodgers. Another first down for the Steelers.
Pittsburgh on the move, 2:55 to play here in the first. From the Jacksonville 30. Bell sets up in the slot. Miscommunication. Incomplete. Maybe on Bell, the intended target, he drew Boye on the outside.
Yes, a zone coverage there that time by the Jaguars. And a little wheel route by Le'Veon Bell. Bell is deep.